أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا وطبيب نفوسنا وحبيب قلوبنا أبي القاسم محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم لا سيما بقية الله روحي وأرواح العالمين لمقدمه الفداء اللهم كن لوليك الحجة ابن الحسن صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائه في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum jami'an wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Congratulations on the birth, auspicious birth anniversary of Sahib al-Asr wa al-Zaman, our Savior, Imam al-Hujjah, Ajjalallahu ta'ala, Farajahu al-Sharif. Alhamdulillah that we are observing the happy occasion of the birth anniversary of Sahib al-Zaman. Last night, as majority of the communities around the world is celebrated, tonight for some communities who consider tonight the night of 15th of Sha'ban. Having said that, let me just quickly clarify something, inshallah, and get into the topic for tonight briefly before, inshallah, we start Dua Kumail, because tonight we have Munajat Sha'bani as well, so I shouldn't keep you long. The question is that, Sheikh, was last night the night of 15th of Sha'ban, or tonight is the night of 15th of Sha'ban? Because some centers are observing it tonight, some they observed it last night. In other words, is tonight the evening of the 15th of Sha'ban or the eve of the 15th of Sha'ban? Brothers, especially when it comes to mustahabbat, don't worry about such issues much really. Because the reason that you want to know exactly when is the night of 15th of Sha'ban is what? Is it because of the celebration that you are concerned about? I tell you, the practice of Ahlul Bayt was that they were celebrating for three consecutive days. This is well reported from the birth of Imam Musa al-Kazim alayhi salam, that when Imam Musa al-Kazim alayhi salam was born, Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam hosted friends, community members for 3 days, but we refer to it today as a celebration. So last night you could well celebrate the birth of Imam Zaman, tonight you can celebrate, tomorrow night you can celebrate, there is absolutely no problem with that, and also more than that. Or is it because you say that, no, but what about the A'mal and the rituals of the night of 15th of Sha'ban? Again, narrations, authentic narrations confirm that the night of 15th of Sha'ban is the second in significance to the Laylatul Qadr. Even for Laylatul Qadr, Abu Basir is coming to Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam and says, Ya Ibn Rasulullah, we started the month of Ramadan in a day, and now some caravans have come from somewhere else, and they say that they saw the moon, and now there is a dispute about the actual night of Qadr. Is the night of Qadr tonight or tomorrow night? Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam tells him, Ya Abu Basir, what's the big deal? You observe Laylatul Qadr tonight and tomorrow as well. So that was for Laylatul Qadr, let alone the night of 15th of Sha'ban. You observe the night, the A'mal of Laylatul Qadr last night, do it tonight again as well for precaution. What's the problem? It's not like that, astaghfirullah, if you come tonight and they say that, look, you've come out of the office hours. Or you went last night and you say that, no, I don't want to make a mistake. As if like, if I had observed the A'mal of 15th of Sha'ban last night, then they have it meant nothing because I had done it out of the office hours. This is not like wajibat, that if I pray out of the pray time, Salat al-Fajr, it's not accepted. But for mustahabbat, there is no such issue, so please don't worry. Even if you did it like us, alhamdulillah, last night, tonight again, by all means, you can repeat and do the amal of Laylatul Qadr. So tonight is the night of the birth anniversary, or was the last night the night of the birth anniversary of Sahib al-Zaman, and at the same time it was the birth anniversary of Dua Kumail. You remember that Dua Kumail initially was said by Amirul Mu'mineen, as reported of course. The first time that was reported happened to be on the night of 15th of Sha'ban. That's why last week I spoke about briefly a glance on the Dua Kumail, so that inshallah tonight we can relate it to the birth of Imam Zaman and the present situation of this common enemy called COVID-19 a little bit. First of all, let me tell you, brothers and sisters, dua is one of the best means of communication with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For those who want to open a communication, dua, it means experimental communication. Dua, in fact, is knowing God in an intuitive way, internally. When you communicate, when you speak with God through the supplications, and you're truly a supplicant, not a reciter. Often we are reciters, not supplicant. The supplicant is like a beggar, desperate. Once we reach to that stage of desperation and we really open the communication, then you experience God. The Almighty God in the Quran, in various ayat, in similar tone, I quote one of them in Surah Al-An'am, that the Almighty God says that if you want to read between the lines, do you want me to tell you why often I seize you, I afflict you with difficulties, calamities, affecting your wealth, affecting your health, affecting your family life? فَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِالْبَأْسَاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَضَرَّعُونَ. These are excuses. Read between the lines. I want you to come back to me and open the communication with me. Because unfortunately, when the ship of your life is sailing smoothly, by and large, we become heedless. غافل. The Almighty God wants to wake us up. And therefore, such situations, experiences such as this issue of COVID-19, definitely these are wake-up calls for those who are supposed to wake up. What are we supposed to call and ask in these nights, now that it's the time of supplication? What is the best supplication and the most important supplications, especially during this difficult time? I quote from the words of Imam Zaman, Ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif. Imam al-Hujjah, Ajjalallahu farajahu sharif, has written a letter, and through one of his ambassadors has been delivered to us. Very famous, we call it Tawqi'. This Tawqi', or the holy letter of Imam Zaman, some parts of it, our jurists, they refer to it a lot. I'm quoting another part, where Imam Zaman says, أَكْثِرُ الدُّعَى بِتَعْجِيلِ الْفَرَجِ فَإِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ فَرَجَكُمْ. Frequently, pray frequently for the hastening of the relief. Relief here, it means the reappearance of Sahab al-Zaman. Then the Imam says, فَإِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ فَرَجَكُمْ. If you want the relief, your relief is in the reappearance of Sahib al-Zaman. عَجَّلَ ta'ala فَرَجَوْ sharif. So the best dua, and that's why there was a universal call coming from different parts and our leaders, to call your Mahdi Adrekni. You recall 8:30, it was for last night, because most part of the world, last night they were celebrating the night of 15th of Sha'ban. So tonight also, and in these nights, inshallah, I will tell you again, back it up by the hadith of Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, we can continue all the way through the month of Ramadan as well, to ask constantly. Remember the instruction that we have during this time of major occultation from Imam al-Hujjah, Jalallahu Farajahu Sharif himself, is أَكْثِرُ الدُّعَى بِتَعْجِيلِ الْفَرَاجِ. Bring the dua for the quick reappearance of Sahib al-Zaman on the top of your supplications. Give it the first priority if you really want تَعْجِيلِ الْفَرَاجِ. So what is happening today in today's world? How can we relate it? Some, they say that this is one of the signs before the coming of Imam Zaman. You don't need to be Einstein to say that with all respect, because obviously we live the time of the major occultation, which means the time before the reappearance of Sahib al-Zaman. So anything happens is one of the phenomena before the coming of Sahib al-Zaman. What I believe, and I take it from the Quran and the Riwayat, is that COVID-19 that has affected the world globally is a wake-up call for us. At least for us believers, we should take heed into it, and we should take lessons from it for what we need. For a believer, brothers and sisters, anything happens in your life, remember this principle. Anything happens in our life, there are always messages in it. Always think about it. What message is in that? inna fi dhalika la'ibratan li'ulil absar. We have this expression used in the Quran a couple of times or more than that in similar formats. Inna fi, God mentions about the story of the nations of the past, different events, and then says, look, the reason that I told you is not because I wanted to tell you stories to put you to sleep. Inna fi dhalika la'ibratan. These were lessons to take heed. As long as you are among the ulil absar, as long as you have the insight, your heart, the eyes of your hearts are open. A blind man turned around and asked a wise man that, is anything worse than losing eyesight? He said, yes, losing insight. As long as you have not lost insight, God forbid, anything happens, there are lessons to draw. Amir al-Mu'minin, salamullah alayhi, he says that, fi kull tajribatin maw'idha, for the believer, fi kull tajribatin maw'idha, in every experience there is an admonition, there is a lesson to learn from. Now I want to see what lessons can I take from this COVID-19, this situation that has affected the world. Tonight I want to give a suggestion. It's hypothetical perhaps, but it is not far-fetched and it is very healthy and useful for us to prepare us before this dua kumil inshallah, and to pray desperately for the hastening the reappearance of Sahib al-Asr wa Zaman. What it is, I want to suggest tonight that let's change the name of this COVID-19, call it major occultation. In this, for the reason, there's a similarity in between, and I'll show you some similarity. The similarity is that COVID-19 is a universal phenomenon, isn't it? Has affected humanity at large. Unlike flood that affected certain states, unlike earthquake that affects certain parts of the world, unlike, I don't know, famine and things, but this has exceptionally, unprecedentedly affected humanity. Major occultation also is for humanity at large. Another thing is that it's invisible, this common enemy of humanity. Major occultation is also invisible. Unless you have faith in God, you'll see it. Otherwise, it's not visible to you. Another similarity is that it's fatal, it's killing, this COVID-19. Yani it's killing some people, unfortunately. You see the rate of fatality around the world. Major occultation is also, unfortunately, killing some, killing their faith, and they're losing their faith, okay? So COVID-19 has disabled mankind. Medical experts today, they say that we have not discovered any vaccination or medication for this COVID-19. Isn't it? Major occultation also. We know the cure, but we don't have the cure yet, because the cure for major occultation is the reappearance of Sahib al-Asr wa Zaman. Now, and as we have not achieved, as humanity has not achieved the vaccination or the cure for COVID-19, likewise, humanity has not achieved the cure for major occultation, meaning that Imam Zaman has not appeared yet. Now, that's why I say that let us, why do I give this similarity? Because I want to put you and myself, inshallah, tonight in this situation. Suppose, between brackets, as I'm talking to you, one of my very dear friends in Sweden is affected by this COVID-19. May the Almighty God give quick recovery to him and all those affected, inshallah, ya Rab. Now, the nearer and dearer someone who is affected with this COVID-19 to you, the more you will be stressed, let alone if it is yourself. Tonight, I want to urge you, brothers and sisters, and everyone, let us assume that my COVID-19 is the major occultation, and I'm affected by it. Because if you have not been, inshallah, affected by COVID-19, for sure you're affected by the major occultation, because you live the time of major occultation, okay? So if that one is possibility, this one is certain. All right, so I am afflicted, ya Rab, by this virus, by this fatal virus, by this plague, by whatever you call it, tribulation of major occultation. Ya Rab, I'm looking for vaccination, and there is no vaccination for it other than reappearance of Sahib al-Zaman. صاحب العصر و زمان will reappear sooner or later. یا رب انشالله sooner. In the knowledge of God, there is a date that for sure صاحب العصر و زمان will reappear and will spread peace and justice on earth. Jesus Christ, عليه السلام, will pray behind him. All what they mention in authentic narrations. Okay? The thing is that your dua, our dua, and especially if we pray together collectively, if we bring the Al-Faraj to the top of our supplications, and seriously and desperately we pray, like Azimov, I'm affected by COVID-19, that's how desperately I pray to God, then the Almighty God will hasten reappearance of Sahib al-Asr wa al-Zaman. Allow me to support this with a hadith from Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, inshallah, and with that I will conclude. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam says, look, Israelites, they suffer for years by the tyranny and oppression of Fir'aun, la'natullah alayhi. Okay? Until they all decided to collectively, men, women, children, فَضَجُّوا وَبَتَوْا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ أربعين صباحاً. I think that's the word of the hadith. That Imam Sadiq alayhi salam says they wailed and cried to the Almighty God collectively, all of them, for 40 mornings. That's what I say. Let's continue this all the way, inshallah, to the end of the month of Ramadan this year. There must be a wisdom that this is happening, this COVID-19 is happening in the month of Rajab, Sha'ban, may continue to the month of Ramadan, so that you can easily read between the lines, connected to the actual causes of suffering being the time of the major occultation. By the way, Imam Sadiq alayhi salam says that because they desperately, collectively prayed and asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for relief, the Almighty God sent Prophet Musa alayhi salam and his brother Harun alayhi salam to deliver them. Look at the wording of the Imam. Imam says that it was meant Fir'aun, the tyranny and the oppression of Fir'aun would eventually expire. Everyone has expiry date, okay? Imam Sadiq alayhi salam says, but the oppression of Fir'aun was meant to expire in 170 years to come, eventually. Because of the community collectively prayed and asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for faraj, the Almighty God brought it 170 years earlier. And they were delivered from the oppression of Fir'aun. Then Imam Sadiq alayhi salam concludes and he says, Ha kada antum lo fa'altum la farrajallahu anna. Similarly, likewise, if you also collectively, seriously, and sincerely pray all for the hastening of the reappearance of Sahib al-Zaman, your faraj and your relief will be hastened, inshallah. With that, before we start the Akumain, inshallah, allow me to recite this dua al-faraj. There are two dua faraj. One, Allahumma kun li waliyyik. Another one, that Imam al-Zaman ajjalallahu farajahu al-sharif. Being the eve or the evening of the night of 15th of Sha'ban especially, I want to quote this dua from the holy lips of Imam al-Zaman. Remember, I told you that Shaykh al-Kaf, Amir rahmatullah alayhi, narrated that one of the followers or the lovers of Ahlul Bayt innocently was imprisoned, and Imam Sahib al-Zaman Ajalla Farajul Sharif attends him and teaches him this dua to be relieved. Ya Rab, we are also jailed in this current situation. Deliver us, relieve us with the dua of Sahib al-Zaman, and especially when you read the dua from the holy lips of Ma'asun, it will be more effective, inshallah. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد اللهم عظم البلاء وبرح الخفاء وانكشف الغطاء وانقطع الرجاء وضاقت الأرض ومنعت السماء وأنت المستعان وإليك المشتكى وعليك المعول في الشدة والرخاء اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وللأمر الذين فرضت علينا طاعتهم وعرفتنا بذلك منزلتهم ففرج عنا بحقهم فرجا عاجلا غريبا كلمح البصر أو هو أقرب يا محمد يا علي يا علي يا محمد اكفياني فإنكما كافياي وانصراني فإنكما ناصراي يا مولانا يا صاحب الزمان الأمان 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 الغوث 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 أدركني 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 الساعة 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 العجل 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 يا أرحم الراحمين بمحمد وآله الطاهرين صلوات اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجه.